I have seen so many people who use Endnote struggle with setting up the font and spacing of the reference list inside of Microsoft Word. In this very, very short video, I'm going to show you how to make your reference list in APA format without unlinking the citations. This time-saving tip is very useful for any document that you might need to edit in the future. Now, of course, you could do it the old-fashioned way, and many people I know are still doing this, where you go to convert citations in bibliography and you convert it to plain text. I remember when I used to do this, I used to have two different versions of a document, and sometimes that would cause unnecessary work and problems. So I've switched to doing it this new way. The problem with using the default settings is that it's going to make the page numbering off in your document if you have a large document with a table of contents. If you're doing a thesis proposal, that's probably you. And if you ever need to remove a reference in the future, it becomes a little bit of a hassle if you have to go back and forth between the EndNote and the not EndNote version of your document. Fixing this is actually very simple. Let me show you how. First, you go to the EndNote tab, right here. And then instead of converting your citations, what I want you to do is click on this little arrow here with the that looks like it's coming out of a box. It'll bring up the configure bibliography menu. And all you need to do is go over to the layout tab. And here, it's just taking a second. And here you can choose whatever font is gonna match your document. So I'm gonna choose Times New Roman because this document is in Times New Roman, 12-point font. And then you can change your spacing as well. So double spacing. You click OK. And now anytime you add or remove a reference, it's going to update and it'll be in the same font as the rest of your document. I hope that this time-saving tip is helpful for you. I use EndNote a lot, so if you have any tips and tricks that you'd like to share with me, please go ahead and throw them in the comments below. Or if you have questions about using EndNote and think maybe I have the answer, maybe you've had a hard time finding the answer to it online, please put it in the comments below as well. I see a lot of people struggling with EndNote and it is such a useful tool if you learn how to use it. I like to fix any APA errors in EndNote and then update the reference list instead of unlinking it. If you're a PhD student, it is well worth the time to have your EndNote with all of the right information so that every time you use a particular reference, it's going to be formatted properly. Thank you, have a good day, and let me know if there's something else I can help you with.